Alright, now all we need to do is find Dandelion wherever he's buggered off to.
Come on, Roach.
Took the liberty of dumping off some stuff we didn't need. I was carrying around a lot, like 3 pairs of boots. I didn't really need, that's probably bugging some of you guys. Don't need that many boots.
Not good. Not good.
Ooh,
no discounts, no.
Come on, Roach.
Behind the wall though. So maybe one of Horson Junior's men.
Slow now. Whoa.
You right there, Dandelion?
How do you make a living? No monster.
Polly, everything all right?
Polly.
Open up.
Let's just steal all the stuff.
What's the ruckus about?
Polly and her half-brained fiancé. They're fighting. She's the only one in this town who knows anything about choreography, and that lummox won't let her work for me. Hold on. What are you doing here? We were gonna meet at the Rosemary.
We were, but you didn't show. Priscilla started to worry, so I came to see how you were doing.
Priscilla started worrying about me? That's so nice.
Less for her than for you, I'm sure. So let's get back.
Did you not hear what's going on in there? We've gotta help Polly. Why do beautiful women always end up with such dicks?
No idea. Stand back. I'll break the door down.
Wait! Do we have to destroy her house? She keeps a spare key around here somewhere.
How would you know she keeps a spare key around here?
It's not as if we started working together yesterday. Before Polly joined forces with Hubio...
You'd visit her? Often?
I'd hide out here while Priscilla and Polly rehearsed at the Rosemary in Time. They worked on the dance numbers. I composed.
So, Polly's not one of your...
I never mix business and pleasure.
The one exception being Priscilla.
Yeah.
Who you were just saying is worried about us. So enough of the chatter and start looking.
Fine. Let's find the key.
Let's find the key. What could it be?
Darkness everywhere.
Find anything?
I see it all around.
Not here.
I would think they put it right by the door there.
Not so.
Not here.
Oh. I'm surprised. Got it.
The key.
The key.
What's it like?
Let's open the door.
Whoa! What the devil's this? Get out of my ass!
Watch it, and leave the woman alone.
What the f- She's my betrothed!
But I'm not your property!
I love her! I'll not let her sway her ass in his brothel!
Whoa! Slow down there a minute. This is clearly one gigantic misunderstanding. One I can clear up in the blink of an eye.
Shove your excuses up your ass!
Ooh.
Sod off, or I'll split your skull!
Damn.
My friend asked you nicely, so please be courteous in return and hear him out, or we'll settle this another way.
All right, talk.
Hubio, right? Polly's told me so much about you. She said you're erudite and have an open mind.
You said that? Well, there's a truth to it. My mind's the open salt, but its open saltedness ends when my betrothed starts wagging her ass around brothels. Get out of here, both of yous. Polly's not going anywhere.
Let him finish. There's no brothel involved.
You see, friend, Geralt just hit the nail on the head. For what you have there is the old publicity placard.
Hmm.
Old?
Very. From a time when my establishment was under different management. I, however, would never let any indecency take place in my cabaret. My very reputation precludes it.
So, what's all this about?
Your betrothed is a first-class artiste, and I want to offer her a position worthy of her talents. She's to be my choreographer, and that in turn means she'll receive a share of the proceeds from every performance she choreographs.
Which means money.
You mean to say coin?
Yeah.
And fame. No flirting required. You have my word.
Suppose... In that case,
suppose it's all right.
You'd agree.
It's settled then. See you at the Rosemary, Polly.
Well, I'm off.
That worked easy
enough. I'll catch up to you. Whew. Never expected that to go so well.
You handled it well, Dandelion. Man was buddying your hands once you called him erudite.
In negotiation, as in combat, the key is to find your opponent's weak spot and exploit it to the hilt.
I know why I'm buttering him up.
Time to head back.
I've still got to stop by Rotlix. Commissioned some new placards from him a while ago, but Hubio came across the old version. Plowing artists got some serious explaining to do.
Who's Rotlix?
Never heard of him? Hank Rotlick, famous portrait artist?
Commissioned a portrait artist to paint your placards?
Henry's an old friend, needed the coin. And I decided we needed new placards to promote the opening performance. Seats won't fill themselves, you know.
That's very true. Let's see, I'll get those placards.
I'll go see Rotlick. You head back to the Rosemary, or Priscilla will have my head.
Really? You'd go?
You go?
Send
really?
That for the hell of it. Tell me where he lives.
Portside.
See you soon.
I just said it for the hell of it. Alright, so... That was great fun. He was like, well, if there's coin involved, that's fine. Ooh, she's not getting undressed and stuff. Then I'm fine with it. Phone with me, Mrs. Stratton, her stuff on the stage. But yeah, if she's... I wonder if she's actually going to be a choreographer or whether Dandelion was just bullshitting her. Because she looks too pretty to be the one kind of teaching. You know, teaching is usually done by some old woman, some old middle-aged woman, fat woman or something, you know. It's not usually done by a delightful lady. Usually done by an older lady, is my point. Oh, we'll see. It may just be a cunning ruse by a Dandelion to get a nice piece of talent on the stage for the cabaret. Same voice actor, I recognize that. Alright. Money collectors. Great.
Looking for Rotlick.
You ain't alone. Damn halfling's in debt to half the city. But I'm here to scrape mine before the carcass is picked clean.
I see.
It's not enough for everyone, so bugger off.
Bugger off?
Feeding time's first come, first served.
That's not very nice.
You're not gonna rob him.
Strange, don't recall asking your permission. Hmm. Get him, Fred!
Oh, great. Punch up to... Oh, I don't want to punch up. I want to hit the bugger. Gotta keep us separated. If they get two on one, I'm done for. Ah. Ah, both come in.
Damn.
Kibad.
Not good.
Can't get out of here. What the fuck? Let me get down the stairs, damn it. Jeez. Okay. Rah. I'm not doing too well with this. One down. Keep him in the corner. Nope. Come on, parry. Parry your
surrender.
He wasn't parrying very well.
Damn it!
Placards.
There ain't no plowing placards here.
Ah.
And Rodlick, where's he?
Same place as always. Vehicle bud estate. Losing his last crowns at the races.
See? Wasn't that easy? Could have said so right away.
Indeed. Stupid bandits. So they're not money collectors, they're bandits. So I don't feel bad about beating them up. I'll just be taking these. But yeah, I hate it when you do the punch up thing and you can't run. You're like, I'm gonna walk very slowly away from you. But yeah, for some reason the parry was really poor. I'm not sure what that's about. It happens sometimes in the punch-ups. Let's go talk to Rotlek. No, he pronounced his name Rotlek. Come on, horsey.
Ah!
You call this living, Witcher?
Come on, Roachy Roach.
I sod it.
Sod it.
I tell you, this city will devour itself.
What's this tripe now, mate? It's not this tripe. I serve the eternal fire.
Here we are. Alright. And a bit more. Looked like we were about to get there, but I guess it's... Is it on the edge of town? Let's find out where it is. Oh god, it's miles away. Yeah. I thought it was closer than that. Right, so we could fast travel to the wheat fields. That'd probably be a good idea. Hang on, won't that take us outside? Yeah, that's what we're in.
Faster.
Travel point. And we'll go to the wheat field. Oh, the Vengelbird residence, actually. That would work. Since that's where they said he'd be. But it's not this entrance, it's the other entrance. Oh, does this mean we're going to have to do some horse racing?
Into the lead. Well, Rotlek, seems you're a considerable sum in the red, but you shan't back out on that account, eh?
You won't have much of a choice before long.
Come now, old sport. We can't allow that. Who'd I wager with then, eh?
Listen, you go your way, here's what we'll do.
We'll make one more bet. If you win, I'll pay your debts and we'll continue playing. What do you say?
Oh, great.
And if I lose?
One worry at a time, old chum. Well, I have to place my bet.
Kiss my ass.
What charming.
You, Rotlek?
Henry Rotlek. Artist, painter, debtor, and martyr to my art. At your service.
Dandelion sent me.
Oh, yes. Well, tell him his placards are done and safely hidden away. Yet, alas, I cannot fetch them. As a group of angry creditors has seized my home.
Think I might have run into one of them.
Then you know my predicament. And now Count de Louverton has offered me the chance to win it all back. I'm to wager on a race.
What's there to worry about? This is your chance to settle up, get a clean slate.
We've had a spell of bad luck lately. Should I agree to De Louverton's offer and lose, I shall be in bondage to him for all time.
So we can either pay the debt, we can do the race. Well, Dandelion doesn't get his placard. Let's try the race. We're probably gonna lose.
Let's do this.
But screw it.
I'll enter the race. You'll bet on me. Win, pay your debts, then give me the placards.
You are that good a rider.
Far from the worst. Go tell the Count you accept his offer.
Far from the worst. Far from the best as well. But whatever. Bugger's got a lead on me. Oh, just passed him. Keep an eye on that old stamina there. He's pretty much gonna rubber band me, I suspect, but get stuffed. Damn it. Keeps passing me, the son of a bitch.
Yeah.
No. I should just run the whole way. Hey! I think I got it. Or did I?
Thank you.
Ooh.
I never expected this. May I ask to what I owe this generosity?
Let's just say I like to do a good deed from time to time.
Just a good Samaritan.
Can we get those placards now?
I'll bring them to the Rosemary in time. Just as soon as I settle my obligations.
Fine. See you there.
All right, that was easy enough. Let's go back to the first travel point and tell Dandelion the good news, hopefully. Had a lovely crash there. Thankfully, it ended, it gave it a save before the end of the race. Well, after the end of the race, what am I talking about? So I didn't have to do it all again. Thank goodness. Let's have a look at the whole map. We want that. Go tell Dandelion the good news. We won the race. I can't believe it. I mean, the tactic I use is basically like save the stamina for the final furlong or whatever you want to call it, the final leg of the race. Just save your stamina for that and gallop to the win. Though that was calling it quite fine. I was a bit close for comfort. I didn't mean to do it. Oh, very nice.
A performance by the illustrious duo, Master Dandelion and Priscilla.
He's doing full swing.
Start in G major and...
Well. See, the crew's been hard at work. Not bad.
No, not all. But I'd imagine something more, you know, more theatrical.
Okay.
Don't you like it? But I thought a boudoir would be right in line with your tastes.
Oh, you chose it. Well, I'm not saying bad, just different. Not exactly what I'd envisaged. You know, now that I think about it, you're absolutely right. A boudoir is the perfect setting for a cabaret. What about Rotlick? Did you get the placards?
Rotlick said he'd bring them on his own. Should be here soon.
Great! The best way I can think of to promote the chameleon.
Never mentioned wanting to change the name.
Rosemary and Thyme wasn't all bad, but it conjured images of Temerian cuisine served by waitresses in peasant garb. Chameleon's a lot better for a cabaret.
Is
apart
it?
From which it emphasizes that the place has undergone a transformation. Just a better ring to it all round.
Chameleon, I guess.
What about choreography? Prepared anything special for the opening?
We haven't. But Polly has. She's priceless. Came in and brought the girls in line before I could say knickers. Premiere will have the audience on their feet, on their knees, both at the same time.
Okay. Do we get to see this grand opener?
Guess everything's ready. So when's the opening?
Soon. We start our dress rehearsal in an hour. I just need to nip back home for my dress.
Sweet.
Thanks for everything.
Don't mention it.
Seems my cabaret dreams are about to come true. So, around to celebrate? I'm buying.
Why not?
That's my boy. The foreman mentioned he saw you and Priscilla talking.
He saw right.
And she say anything about me?
Fan, you smell.
She said you've gained some weight and that you should bathe more often.
Very funny, Geralt. Shove it.
Well, well. Never thought I'd live to see the day. Dandelion living in monogamy.
I've always been monogamous. Well, near enough. I just changed muses often.
Priscilla, another one for your collection?
No, she's its crowning glory.
One thing's eating me. How do you manage to get the loan from Sophronia?
Ugh, wasn't easy. She got so excited about our performance, I had to read to her for 4 hours. 4 hours from the cloak and the dagger.
You mean you didn't?
Are you crazy? Who do you think I am? She's late, of course. She knew how important this night was to me.
Of course she did. Probably just making herself gorgeous. Takes time.
So it's true. A woman's vanity knows no bounds.
Master Dandelion! Priscilla, she's...
What? Speak, man!
She's badly,
attacked.
They took her to Vormerius Hospital.
Aww.
Attacked? She's hurt? Geralt, come with me, please.
What a shame.
Of course, let's go.
I was expecting a performance and...
Gods. Priscilla. Is she gonna live?
Son of a bitch.
Well, I'd say that's certain. Her condition's critical but stable. Beg your pardon, but you are a relative?
Relative? No, a friend. A very close friend.
Dandelion, correct? She uttered the name in her few moments of lucidity. I am Joachim von Gratz, head of surgery. Until recently, a lecturer at Ochsenfurt Academy.
Enough of the courtesies. What are her injuries, besides her eye?
A concussion, cranial swelling, incision into her larynx, and scalding inside the throat and esophagus. Clearly someone forced her to imbibe a caustic fluid.
So this was no ordinary attack, no robbery.
Clearly not. It was the act of a demented mind, and not its first.
How can you know that?
I've seen wounds like this. They're not the kind one would forget, don't you agree? In fact, just this week, a corpse turned up in the morgue with similar injuries. And no heart.
No heart? You mean that might have happened to Priscilla? Is someone looking into this?
This is Novigrad. Only the innocent burn here.
Geralt, I know I owe you 100 times over, but I need to ask you another favor. Find the bastard who did this. Find him. And kill him.
Don't need any convincing. Come on, Dandelion. Let's think about what we can do.
I would suggest examining the previous victim's corpse. It has yet to be autopsied. Doing so could very well provide some clues. No need to look astonished, gentlemen. As a surgeon, I know the importance of preventive medicine. Rather than wait for this maniac to strike again,
I'd prefer to excise him. Not unlike a tumor.
Great analogy, but this tumor's not gonna sit there, wait to be excised. Appreciate the help, but I doubt you know what you're getting yourself into.
I know perfectly well, and I assure you I can take care of myself.
Easy assurance to make, harder to back up, especially if you've spent your whole life wielding a scalpel, not a sword.
Look at this scar. Don't be shy. Any idea what leaves such a mark?
A flail. Morningstar, maybe.
What do you think? A blow sustained at the operating table? No? Let me repeat, I know what I'm doing, and I wish to help.
Think they'll let me into the morgue?
By the main entrance, certainly not. But you can also get inside through the sewers.
The sewers? Travel them often, Doctor?
As often as required for, the pursuit of preventive medicine.
Alternative treatments. Aggressive ones, I'm guessing. Interesting.
We can discuss this en route. Are you ready?
No. Need to tend to something first.
In that case, we shall meet by the Kingfisher. I'll await you there.
I'll get whoever did this, Dandelion. Even if it's Hierarch Hemelfart himself.
Thanks.
Yeah, well, this is a turn up for the books, isn't it, guys? Well, that sucks. That really sucks. I wasn't expecting that. Need to find out who did this and mete out divine retribution upon him. On plus side, there's a lot of good stuff here.
Oh, it'll rain, no doubt.
Nice. Anyway, guys, that's unfortunately all we've got time for. So next up, we'll be trying to find what happened, pretty much. What happened to poor Priscilla, and who's doing this to people and why? Sounds like the job of some kind of serial killer or something. But yeah, we'll see if we can bring him to justice. Till next time, guys.